Hey, I'm Decathlon Gamer, and welcome back to PCM 23 Lions. This is episode 93. We're going to be wrapping up the Tour de France with stages 19, 20, and 21. Now, stage 19, with the King of the Mountains wrapped up, is no longer important for us, but it is important for Benyam Girmay for the sprint classification, which he currently leads. Let's go ahead and do the sim to see how he fares in this stage. Philipsen takes second. Delai is fourth. They were the ones just behind him. Girmay only getting sixth today. Very much was the strong guy at the beginning stages. Is a bit weak now, so he could be in trouble with the final stage because he definitely lost points today. A lot of points. Holy crap. 50 for winning the stage, but it was more than that, right? Girmay. Down to a 2-point advantage over Delai. Philipsen just 4 behind. 3-horse race, 1 stage to go. And Girmay looks like somebody who was in the same situation that our team was in. That being front-loaded, fitness peak early, struggling in the final week. But with 0 KOM points left to go for the entirety of the race, you can see Ashimwe has secured his position. No change in the standings other than Pellizzari lost time today, dropping behind Pidcock. Which I think he lost about 10 minutes or so. Arab was only 4 minutes ahead of him, so it does give him a little bit more of a cushion there. Stage 20, first test. I've had 3 guys out so far, and I've been playing around with it a little bit, and I've not found a happy zone. You have to save a lot for the climb. That's what I'm finding. There's so much time gained or lost on the climb. So I'm starting to back off more and more. I was going a 70 out, and then second sector going at about a 73 or a 72, and both of those are too hard. I'm seeing that even though you make progress and you do okay on the time trial, it's the climb where time is significantly gained or lost, and it's minor time. You might lose 2 minutes on the flat, but you save so much for the climb that you gain 4 minutes or 5 minutes. Matoni, strong time trialist, even on a 68, has put in the best time so far at the first time check. And Jansen is coming up towards it, and he's going to be okay. He's not a very good time trialist, though. He's more of a climber, which is why we've backed off a little bit more with him. Matoni, this is one area where I kind of want to push a little bit, and I've been pushing a little bit, but we're not going to do so this time. Again, really trying to save more and more of it for the climb at the end. Yeah, you can see Soler pushing harder on the climb. But Tony can climb, and as a time trialist, he can put in a pretty decent time on this, we hope. Not a great time trialist, but a strong climber, so we want to do the same sort of thing. We'll back off a little bit more, 67 for him. Tony, down to the flat, save it through here, save it for the climb. Jansen, almost to the top. Okay, start to speed up a bit for Matoni, and we're climbing. He was second, 3 seconds down at the time check there. Meanwhile, backing off for Jansen. Okay, Shimwe's still going, Matoni. We can push even harder here. We saved enough, that's the thing. We have saved enough. We are climbing a lot faster. Now second at the first time check. Final kilometer for Matoni. 800 meters. It's going to bonk out here really soon. Across the finish line, fourth. Minute 33 down. That's the thing. We were so strong, and so we didn't evaluate the climb well at all. Oh, Jansen. Jansen. Give me that 86. 2K to go for him. Ashimwe. Okay, on this section, needs to push harder through there. Final kilometer for Jansen. He was 5.5 minutes down. Coming up, final 400 meters, final push, final attack, 64th, 8:32. So you can see how it can go horribly wrong. And Tony found balance. Here comes Arab. Okay. Oh, he's got a plus 5. Yes. Oh, he's going to be good. Okay, Ashimwe in the rest stage. Plenty left for him. Samuels is coming up soon. Filippo Ganna is the fastest right now. Had a Bitziger and Aragave and Gills. Tony is fifth. Tony is fifth right now on a flat for a Shimway and speeding up. Okay, 241 down. We'll give him that 86 and see how it goes. Meanwhile, Arab up. Okay. Only a minus one. A minus one for Samuels is actually good. He is done with this race. He's now on minus two expected, so that's actually a plus one for him. For Arab, it's like a plus three. Third, sixth place, and he's going to start pushing a little bit more through here. A Shimway, final kilometer, a little too deep there. A little too deep. Oh, he's just now at the final kilometer. Oh, Shimway's going to lose time here. He's 30th overall, though. Doesn't matter. KOM doesn't matter. Goodbye, Mataway. Arab making good time through here. Overtaking guys. Samuel's coming up on that first check. So Sarah, Arab looking so good. I think we could expect to get a very good time out of him. Mutoni's down to 7th already. Roglic goes top. Mataway went 6th. Okay. He was the one who went flying past us. Shimway finished 451 down, 36th overall. Second best for the team still because of the climb. 82 for Arab today means he can put in a pretty solid. He's now 7th at the first time check. Arab is climbing. Let's give him that 70 territory. And Arab start to speed back up. Start to speed up a little bit more, a little bit more. Just slowly ramping up that speed as we begin to climb. Ironsman goes top. 4K. Okay, up to that 86. Samuels will rest here in a moment. Arab 2K. Yeah, we're okay there. Samuels overtaken by Evenepoel. Evenepoel's fourth overall. Jeez. He's flying. 1K. Nope, nope. Arab. 600 meters. Runs out of energy. He'll lose a little bit of time here at the end. But third, 16 seconds. That's a great time. That is a great time. Grégoire, 33rd, 341. We'll be ahead of him. 5K. Samuels starting the climb. Still a good climber. Still can put in a good time. Just starting gradually, building it up. Pogacar goes top. Arensman, Roglic, Arab now off the podium for the stage. No matter. He's gaining substantial time on some of the guys around him. 3K to go. Speeding up, now in 86. 2K, Samuels, backing off just a little bit, 84. 82. 79. He did not have enough left in the tank. There goes Lenny Martinez. And we're done, we're done. 12:26. 12 and a half. Minutes lost for Samuels. We lost 6 minutes in the second sector. That's what a 62 time trial does to you, folks. With a minus one race day condition. Ouch. Pogacar wins the stage. Evenepoel takes second. Vingegaard, Almeida, Arensman, Roglic, Paulus. Arab gets eighth on the stage, though. Minute 38 down, Ghana and Bitsiger. That's a good result for Arab. Vingegaard does take over the race lead from Leknesund on the penultimate stage. Vingegaard wears yellow for the first time of what will be two. Petrovic keeps the podium in third. Evenepoel up to fourth. Almeida down to fifth. Paulus sixth. Pogacar moves up to seventh. I did not see the rest of the top 10. Shimway, confirmation of the KOM. Let's get in there and see what we've got. We got a jersey, though, folks. We got a jersey in our first Tour de France. Oh, man. Oh, both of them missed the top 10. Both of them missed the top 10. And finish with identical time. Now, that's something. That is something. The only same time in the top 20 is literally two riders from our same team. The only other team that's even got anything remotely close to, hold on, that's more than remotely close. Jumbo-Visma's second riders, Enric Mas in 14th. The only other team in the top 10 or top 15 that has two riders together, us, right? 11th and 12th, but La Gruppetto. 8th and 9th, and 13th with Gregoire, and 17th with Pidcock. No wonder they won the team classification. Do we keep second, though? Because we got one good time. We got an okay second time. We don't have a good third time. We could have lost a ton of time on this, which just goes to show how weak our team is in reality compared to everybody else. The only disappointing thing here is we literally miss the top 10 by seconds. Vlasov jumps us. He's a terrible time trialist. He's got a 75? Are you kidding me? I don't see how he's got a 70. Vlasov is awful in the time trial. Godou's got a 70. He's a better time trialist than Vlasov. Martinez drops 3 spots. Leknesud, that's a big one right there, though. Almeida jumps to the top 5 from 7th. Pagacar jumps to 7th. But yeah, Samuel's losing 3 spots. We knew he was going to go backwards. I repeated it many, many times throughout this race. I knew he was going to have a hard time with this. I did not expect him to go that far. He lost 12 minutes. 12 and a half minutes. 12 and a freaking half minutes. That's crazy. Samuels and Arab still both on the podium. 18 minutes down on Petrovic. Fortunato well behind. Ashimwe is 7th. Team classification, we fall to 3rd. But we do get a podium on that one. Disappointing that we don't actually get the top 10 for the tour. Makes no difference to anything. I mean, we're totally fine there. Not actually getting top 10. It's a couple points less, but 11th, 12th still adds up to good points. And more importantly, we've won a jersey and we won 2 stages. And that's what we came here for. We were hoping for 1 stage. Hoping for a chance at the KOM. We wore the leader's jersey for a while. We won the KOM, and we won not one, but 2 stages. And we were hoping for 1, not guaranteeing. We were just optimistic. So, still a very good race. Sad to fall out of the top 10 on the final stage that matters time-wise. Let's go finish the Champs-Élysées, though. Just looking at the top of the screen here are the points. 8,016. We are 4th. This will not update until after the tour. All of the points from the tour will be added in simultaneously. You know, La Gruppetta. Gruppetta will do well. We know Jumbo Visma is going to do well. BNB is already way ahead. So we're probably not going to move up. But let's hope that we can hang on to 4th or 5th. Champs-Élysées, we'll speed up right to the end on this one. But first, checking in. For one, I totally missed something. I thought it said 224, 222, and 220. It's 244, so a 22-point advantage for Girmay. We've already passed the intermediate sprint. Philipsen got 2nd. Girmay was 4th. Delai was 5th. So points are more or less the same, about a 20-point advantage for Girmay heading into the finish. Now, 50, 30, 10, 18. If any of those key guys get in the top 2, those 2 guys chasing, they've got a real shot at overtaking Girmay. Further down, as long as Girmay is in the top 10, they shouldn't overcome him. But Philipsen or Delai, if they get in the top 2, they've got a real chance. 35K to go. Water, one final time for this tour. We're not going to properly compete for this sprint, but we want to get in line before we come around the corner here, so we'll take our chance right now. $10,000 to go, so we're gonna go full gas, starting with Barry. We need gels of these for these front guys. Now we need full gas because we just don't have the ratings. I mean, look how strong those guys are. These first few guys are all about just getting us in position, really. Same with Clote. Clote actually needs to soft sprint here. 6K. He's not even overtaking Mutoni. Right. Clote. There we go. 5K. Gel for the rest. Not hurting his teammates, but you had that little hill section. Now we're on to guys that actually have a flat rating, so Careless. 3.4, starting his sprint, pushing a little bit harder than the others. Now inside 3K, Now it's looking like an actual sprint. A Shimwei is sprinting. 1.5k, and this is the best position. A Shimwei is literally the front rider. This is the best position I've had my team in on a Champs-Élysées sprint in a while. But we don't have a sprinter. So when you look at Arab Samuels Janssen left, they're in good shape, they're in a good position, but Caden Groves is in a better position. Philipsen, not in a very good position, not being led out. Laporte, Girmay, like, they're stronger than Janssen. We're not going to win this, but on to Arab. There go those sprinters. Let's see just how strong they are. That's top eight or so guys. Samuels leading out, and Janssen, final 400 meters. Closest thing to a sprinter we have, and is that... Philipsen takes the win ahead of Girmay. Oh, and then Delai. But it's down to Philipsen or Girmay. There's a 20-point gap between first and second, 50-30. Girmay had a 22-point advantage. We had an intermediate sprint. Philipsen gained 2 points, 3 points. Gained the mountains. I just got an achievement for that. I think Philipsen took it by 1 point. That's my guess. We'll see if that's the case. But Samuels Janssen, 16th, 17th. Vingegaard wins the overall ahead of Leknesund. Samuels, Arab, no change in the standings. Top 20, all the same. Stage, points. 24-point advantage for Philipsen over Girmay. He was 22 behind on the day. He's going to finish 2 points ahead. Girmay gets second at the Champs-Élysées, but does not win the jersey. Delai is going to be third. Philipsen's going to take the green jersey away from Girmay. Are we correct? No. Delai was the one who was second. Philipsen was the one who was third. He was the further couple points behind. They finish on identical 287 points, but Girmay got there first. Philipsen has to take it off of him, meaning he has to exceed the score. So Girmay wins the green jersey. Philipsen wins the Champs-Élysées, matches Girmay, but will not take the jersey. Delai drops to third. That was the difference, that extra 2 points. He was 24 behind, not 22. Again, confirmation of the KOM. Again, confirmation of our top three with two riders in the under 25s, and our confirmation of third overall in the team classification. Let's go ahead and jump forward and see what has happened regarding points. We were just over 8,000. In the end, we had nearly 2,000 points, from 8,016 to 9,961. Radstand claimed the second place overall in the race. Leknesund was their leader. They jump 4 spots to fourth. BMB on top. Jumbo-Visma second. La Gruppetto. It's close still to second. I mean, we're only just over 1,000 points behind. We just got a near 2,000 point haul for that race. That was a difference maker. Now, looking forward, there's one Grand Tour left. It's not going to offer quite as many points as the Tour de France. There's other races. You could expect most teams are not going to score more than 2,000 to 3,000 points the rest of the season. With a plus 3,000 over Plakosmith, we're pretty much guaranteed a top 10 at this point. And with no Continental Pro teams in sight until you get down to Tudor at 4,700, more than double their total, we're going to be in the top three. We've got the top three secured for next season. We've already shattered our record from last season, which was good enough for second in the points, or was it third? Evenepoel is on top ahead of Philipsen. Pogacar, Vingegaard jumps to fourth. Leknesund jumps to fifth. Petrovic, Van Aert, Vanderpoel, Palace, Girmay into the top 10. Samuels jumps to 13th with his performance. Nice. Big points there. He got 930, so he got half of our points. He did win one of the stages. He did wear the yellow. A Shimwei jumps 29 spots to 32nd. He got 590. So for a stage win and a King of the Mountains victory, he got a solid 590 points. Janssen is 45th. Did he get anything? Tour de France, 25 points. Johannes Dalek is 57th. Where the heck is Arab? Arab, there we go. Wow, that shows where he's come. Where he started this season. 375. One position below Samuels on same time. 500 points less. Wearing that yellow, winning that jersey was worth a lot of points. One thing to watch out for is Ashimwe, Rwanda, 32nd. I don't know if that's a high enough position to get a training boost for the coming season. Samuels, 13th, maybe. South Africa's highest finish that they would have had so far. Girmay, another top 10, but we've already seen that training boost for Eritrea once earlier in the series. Not sure it's going to happen again. The question is getting asked more and more often regarding if each rider can only acquire one point, and then it comes down to a diversity of riders to make things happen. Could be. Or it's each rider can only check off each achievement once. You get stage win from Girmay, he gets that first point, but he's already collected that point. Green jersey, not making a difference? I don't know. Ashimwe just finished winning the KOM. We did not get a popularity boost. Or did we, actually? I haven't looked in the email. Maybe we did. Probably not. And in terms of the ranking, Samuels is 13th, Ashimwe 32nd, Janssen is 45th, Johannes Dalek 57th, Carolus 97th, De Villiers 98th, Arab just 108th. Late bloomer this season. Coming on, was injured for quite a while, didn't race for a long time, so makes sense. It does make sense. Even Bari has 3 points. First, looking at Africa, you've got South Africa at 7,600, with Samuels having nearly half of those points. Eritrea, 6,000. Rwanda, 2,000. Morocco, 1,200. In terms of the world rankings, Belgium's on top. Slovenia and Netherlands round out the podium. South Africa, 12th. 12th place for South Africa. Eritrea's 14th. That's pretty damn good. Confirmation that we got no bonus for winning the KOM for Rwanda, so no extra point there. He did get one in the race, though, for winning a stage. San Sebastian is our next race, and then we enter the final phase of the season. We've got the World Championships coming up. We have a largely our team dominant group going to the World Championships. Not entirely, though. GP Hamburg, decent chance at points. We'll see if we can get our sprint team at that one. Plouay, Quebec, Montreal, Il Lombardia to wrap up the season, plus our signing special, which of course will be the next thing right after the San Sebastian race. Therefore, we're looking at, what, 3 episodes to wrap the season, I'd say. And the points are definitely in great shape. It's just whether any of the riders, and really there's only two, Ashimwe and Samuels, who could push their nations for a training point. I don't suspect anybody else is in position to do anything like that. We're pretty fatigued. It's going to be a difficult final stretch of the season. But that's going to do it for this episode. I'm Decathlon Gamer. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Have a good one. Be safe out there. Bye for now.